if you have a look inside a character you loaded from a VRM file, there's a number of directories. In particular, I'm going to have a look at this directory called blend shapes. This is actually for holding blend shape clips. If you start from the first object, what we do is go. This object is actually referred to as a blend shape avatar, and what it does is it's got us a list of all of the blend shape clips. This is like pointing to all the other files in that directory. So if you look at neutral, it's just a normal character expression. Got the sound for making letter A, I, U, so it's the various vowels. How to blink or just do one eye, make an angry expression, some fun expression. And so these expressions are all provided by VRoid Studio when it created this VRM file. But if I have a look at another character, this is another character I created. Everything also looks good, but if you start looking at the blinks, you might notice that the eyelashes don't look quite right. It's going through the skin. If I bring up the actual definition, you can see it a little bit clearer. So what I've done here is I've actually clicked on the actual blend shape clip, and it's the blink one. And so I can pick the strength, and you can see it a little bit more clearly when it goes closed. The eyelashes actually go closed further than what it should. And the problem is that how VRoid Studio works is you can change the structure of a character's face to make them look different, but then when you apply some of the blend shapes, it just can't cope. I've changed the shapes of the eyes in a way that the closing of the eye goes too far now and the eyelashes go too far through. So what you can do is if you have expand this out, so this is the blink, and we've given it the name blink, and there's a set of presets. So the VRM standard is basically using existing standard, but they've defined some extra things. For example, here are some well-known expressions that everybody should support. And the idea then is if you can load this VRM file into different applications, VR-based applications like chat applications and so forth, and you'll know how to make the character do fairly standard sorts of expressions in all of these environments. If you expand out, all of the blend shapes, what you'll find is the blink definition is basically using the eye closed definition. But what you can come in and do is adjusted here, and I've now told it that the blink should only use this blend shape. So this is a list of blend shapes available in the character, which was you'd create using Blender or VRoid Studio builds these ones in, but you can define your own if you get advanced in Blender. And what it allows you to do now is to say, look, I only want to use the eye closed at 80% strength. And so now, when I go back to going to angry, fun, and I go to blink, the eye looks better because it's actually not using that blend shape to full strength. So you can use any combination of the underlying blend shapes to create the expressions you want. You can also, if you click add blend shape clip, you can actually create your own file. You give it some sort of sensible name, and you can define additional expressions. And some of the tools will actually give you buttons, allow you to bind buttons onto your own expressions, which allows you to create more expressions than what is in the standard sort of list, which could be useful in some cases. So if we go into this, go into blink, look at the blink. Expand this out again. So what it can do is if I expand the face list, The blend shapes, you'll notice that we've got this all for angry is because there's an angry eyebrows. I don't know if you can see that very clearly. Then angry eyes. And so you can change all these different things. And so you can combine these things in different ways. So for example, during this one, because it's too strong, I'm going to wind it back. But if you really wanted to, you could, during the closing of the left eye, you could say, well, I really want the eyebrow to move a little bit as well. This is where you start looking at what blend shapes are available, and you discover there is nothing to move only one eyebrow at once. The only ones that exist there move both eyebrows together. And that's one of the problems with the predefined set of blend shapes built in. If it's not what you want, you're in trouble. And I'm going to look at a way later on to actually add your own blend shapes, but that will be probably in a separate recording. Okay. Now the blend shape list here is just another way of showing how the blend shape clip is defined. So it's saying for the face, take the, these are all available blend shapes defined, and what value to set. And so you can add to this list. And it was the same as doing it on the other page, but it's just another representation of the same information. So I can add joy and do all sorts of weird things if I so choose to, but you've got to look at the actual artwork to make sure it's actually making sense and it's not just looking stupid, which it is in this case, so I'm going to get rid of it. So a blend shape clip is sort of like a shortcut way of defining a blend shape of a particular expression on the face, and give a single button click and then turn that expression on, which is useful in a range of applications. So that's what the blend shape list is. It's identifying which blend shapes to include. You may also notice there's this material list. And if you go through all of the built-in blend shapes, none of them use material list. And so I was wondering what it was. And so I was doing a little bit of a play. And if I come over to another one I was experimenting with before, and if I come up with this character, and you might notice that I've got some things on the cheeks. And the way this was done is by using that third tab. So if we look at the surprise definition, I'm going to look at this third tab, which is material list. And what I've got for the material list is this thing here is actually one of several materials related to the face. And so the face has got a list of materials for different parts. And so you can do the artwork for the iris separate to the skin. And what I've done for the skin is if I go into the textures directory, the original face artwork was this bit of artwork. And what I've done is I've snuck in there and I've made two copies of it. So it's one bitmap twice the height, and I've done another version of the bitmap with the cheeks blush put on it. So it's one big bit of artwork, but I've got the normal face with underneath it one with blushing done on it. And so what the idea is, I wanted to use this top square first. And then if I go to surprised, I wanted to use the bottom section. And that's what you can use these materials for, which was quite cool. So if I come into surprised, the material list says tiling is going to be is one for the X, so we're going to use the full X value, and Y is we're only going to use half of the Y value for one image at a time. And this one is offset 0, 0. If I go to neutral, material list, what I did was I said again, the tiling is 1 and 0.5 with an offset of 0 and 0.5. And so it's going to go halfway up. And so this is using the top half of the image, halfway up, and the other one's using the bottom half of the image. Now, I've only updated those two. If I click on something like Sorrow, you'll actually see it's using the top and bottom half of that image across the face, and it looks stupid. And that's because I haven't gone in here and added a material list of saying face, skin, main texture, 0.5, 0.5. I'm going to specify that as 1. And so 1 means the full width, 0.5 means half the height, and here I've specified the offset. And so I've got to go through all of these other blend shapes, clips then, and add this extra material property in. But it allows you, if you wanted to do, in an application like VRChat, you can do blushes and other sorts of visual effects by using tiling of these images, which I thought was quite cool. Now, you can also do other things like saying, I'm going to add another material. I'm going to use the whites of the eye. And this time, I'm going to adjust the color. And orange wasn't quite the look I was after. Is it going to be more a bit red, bloodshot, a little bit paler, so it's not too strong? And now I've got bloodshot eyes as well. Now, if I go back to, say, Hank, we'll have a look at Hank. I'm actually not going to be using these blend shape clips. They are actually quite useful. But if I drag Hank into a scene, the problem I've got personally is there's this blend shape proxy script. And the problem is all the properties for all these blend shapes are not available unless you hit the play button. The proxy script now makes it available, so I can animate all these in an animation clip. But as soon as I exit play mode, they disappear. And so they're a bit of a pain, actually. And so because they're just a shortcut, I can do exactly the same thing in an animation clip. I'm just going to animate all the individual components using animation clips instead. So this was just an introduction to Blend Shape clips. And now I'm probably never going to talk about them again.